What is your secret dream that you wish it would be real? When I was 6 to 9, I kept dreaming of me being a thief and my group of friends on a fantasy adventure. We would go to the guild and fight monsters and travel the world. Haha, wish that was real. Nice. But also, maybe take up D&D? Live out that adventure in your head. Good idea. One problem, monsieur. All my friends were imaginary, hahaha. I was a lonely kid. I can bend an element such as on Avatar, preferably earth or fire. I was gonna say something like that. Bend fire to cook food cause my kitchen sucks. But RN, I want to have a life-changing field trip with Zuko so I can escape working in a fast food restaurant and work out what the frick I'm doing instead of holding in my bloodthirst for Karens or Uncle Iroh for the sage advice and to have a guardian in my life. NT. Always want to try Iroh's hot leaf juice. Awkward teenager or wholesome uncle, I'll take either. To be a mom, I have this fear that I'll never to get pregnant and it constantly breaks my heart. Scared of tests as they might be bad news. I never talk about it, but it would be my greatest joy to have my own kid. I don't know you, but I am certain you'll be a great mother. Understanding enough about myself to use my brain in my favor, not against myself. One day, that one where I could still hold my dog. I am sorry for your loss. Love lasts forever, hold on to that. I have other dreams, but they aren't secret. So my secret one is, I wish I had a girl who loved me so I could wake up feeling loved and want to go to school to see her. Either that or my socks don't get tears. Both work. Start buying better socks. I recommend Smart Wool. Ever fallen in love in a dream? Joyful and content dream. Quickly ripped away with realization and sense of loss for something that didn't even exist when you wake up. That is both a very pleasant dream to be in and a very unpleasant thing to wake up to, and messes with me at least for days or weeks after. Happened a small handful of times that I remember. Most recently, I discovered that when the dream is about someone you know, you get a whole other layer of confusion and shame thrown on top of that loss and disappointment. 2. They say the feeling you have for someone in a dream reflects how you feel for them IRL, whether you realize it or not. I had a dream where I was with this guy. We're friends but not that close. And after I had that dream, I realized I had liked him for a while now. My ex and I to get back together. 11 years and 2 kids. A lot of history and I still love him so much. Been there. It won't give you relief you crave. I know. Thanks for the reminder. Heartbreak sucks. Where I was just happy and content with life. My soul felt that. Get rid of all the bugs in the world. Most life would disappear after that. Most of the organic compounds in the soil that allows us to grow food comes from the masseur. Sorry, I meant all the bugs that don't deserve to live. Ticks, mosquitoes, hornets, wasps, and other things that fucking suck. Wasps are the assholes of the insect world. How about to save the entire world ecosystem? Hear me out. You just wish for a small barrier between you and any bugs of the world? Wanna know why it might have been a secret? So someone doesn't have to deal with gatekeeping and critical review of their secret inner desire. But you know, you do you. If you didn't want your dream to be criticized, you should have put more work into your dream, monsieur. I live in the Pokemon world and all my pets are actually Pokemon. To bring balance to the universe by wiping out half of all life. This does put a smile on my face. What if you fell in the wrong half? A small price to pay for salvation. Werewolf girlfriend, don't judge me. Pretty hard to not judge. Look man, we all have our fantasies. Happy cake day. Well, if you're granting wishes, I wish that the guy the first was supposed to be with would think for himself instead of letting his bullshit family and some random guy tell him that I'm with him for his money. Become an actress. I can cry pretty much on cue. And I'm good at acting. But I'm not good looking and turn beet red when I'm embarrassed. Cry, etc. So I've never tried, but I always felt like I had such potential. At this point, just being an extra in a movie would make me real happy. You don't have to be good looking to be an actress. Like, you can't be Scarlett Johansson. But film and TV always needs people with all kinds of looks. There are people who have made a career only playing funny-looking bearded criminals or wrinkly-faced school teachers. There will be roles out there that need somebody who looks just like you. You should go for it. Stopping time, that is all. My aunt died when I was 14 and she was 43. She was my favorite aunt and I was devastated. When someone dies, I wait for them to come visit me in my dreams. Weird. I know, I'm not religious, consider myself spiritual. Sometimes, they come right away. Other times, I wait a long time. She came to me many years after her death. We were on this beautiful bluff with plants so beautiful. I never seen them before. She was young and beautiful again. We spoke about my life since she left and I felt such peace. We watched the sunset together. Then I woke up. I don't know what heaven looks like, but if it's like that, it was beautiful. Alternate timeline in which my dad's rich as fuck and I don't have to really work. I'd just spend my days chilling in my huge ass pool, playing basketball and chess. Maybe go back to uni again. Med school, not engineering this time. It'd be cool to be a doctor. In fact, I'd settle on an alternate timeline in which I picked med school back when I was 17. Why not just do it and enroll into med school? You've only got one life. It's a lot of work. No way I'd be able to manage with a full-time job. And I have neither the balls to quit nor the inclination to move back in with my parents in order to study. My boyfriend plays in a band and sometimes they play random shows together. Basement show, random house, bar downtown, etc. kind of thing. My secret dream is for him to make a sappy speech and then propose to me at one of those shows. I get all mushy even just thinking about it. I miss my ex and I would love to be friends with him and just talk to him and see what he's up to. I'm married to another man though and I feel guilty for even thinking of my ex. Let alone wanting to catch up with hi Monsieur, it will never happen. It's not a bad thing to think about the past, it was a chapter of your life. You had good and bad times together. You just need to accept that every chapter has an end. You say you are married now. So this is a new chapter. Don't feel guilty. That's not cheating. Thank you. You're right. I appreciate the wise words. Best of luck to you. Anakin didn't stop Palpatine's execution. The Jedi would have still been destroyed. But Anakin and Padme would have been together. That I get to spend a good enough life. Just be able to stay happy until I die and not lose my hope to live anymore. I would like to meet my twin brother. He died when we were born. I felt lonely since I was little. Because my mother can't have any more children. My parents and family gave an incredible amount of love and attention, but I feel incomplete. Or that my cat would still be alive. He died much too early due to a genetic effect. Man, I love this little asshole so much. My music going from 50 to 1 million views overnight. Post a link. Having a dragon friend that could gobble me up. Being happy that I'd wake up one day at 5 feet 6 inches instead of still being a near 6 feet 4 inches cis female. Stand tall, all 6 feet 4 inches of you. You are beautiful. Witches and candy houses. Live in Naruto. I want to live in the 7 deadly sins. You want Isabella, don't you? You mean Elizabeth? No, Jericho is my girl. Stupid autocorrect. Yes, I meant Elizabeth. Jericho kinda bad too. Well, I can choose a Escanor like solitude. I wish I could own and operate a cute cat cafe that adopts out cats that need a home. There would be all these fun cat-themed decor that the cats could use as perches and roots, and there'd be a back area only for the cats where they could go rest and de-stress with calm music. Playing softly, we'd also serve delicious cat-themed coffee and tea drinks and cute little kitty cakes and treats and games. And we'd have kitten socialization classes and free educational courses for kids and for the community to help feral colonies in the area. a dream where I was content. Had people that I loved who loved me and didn't abuse me in one way or another. Had a job that provided and I enjoyed. Had a home to call my own. Man, if only I had a dream like that. I dream to dream that. I wish magic were real. It is. To live in a village with only women. These women all have better than average bra sizes. They're all super horny too. Thanks for reading. Just to find a true friend who'd go through all the hardships of life with me. Someone who I'll probably never to get to meet in my lifetime. Ever fallen in love in a dream? Joyful and content dream. Quickly ripped away with realization and sense of lust for something that didn't even exist when you wake up. That is both a very pleasant dream to be in, and a very unpleasant thing to wake up to, and messes with me at least for days or weeks after. Happened a small handful of times that I remember. Most recently, I discovered that when the dream is about someone you know, you get a whole other layer of confusion and shame thrown on top of that loss and disappointment. 2. That I could instantly download altruism to everyone in the world. Put us all on the same page. Remove people like Trump and Xi Jinping and others. And have a moral court where all knowledge of their ulterior motives and crimes is known. Making them pay for their terribleness while the rest of the world starts really working together. Dismantling horrid industries and building a greener future together. Build cities from the ground up that are actually built around and inspire public transport. Biking. Walking. We need more people like you. My dream was more personal, but I'd set it aside to help you with yours. Happy Blue Cheese Pie Day. Have my upvote. Thank you. No problem, good person. Happy Pride Moth as well. I am a Pride Moth brother. S as hell yeah. Had a dream last night I found a briefcase full of money and banknotes and got to keep it. That would be nice. I've had sexy dreams too. But I honestly would rather have the money, as I never did the thing and would be terrible at it. To get my brain, short-term memory working again. That I wish I could choose and have a loving boyfriend. Off-grid living with state-of-the-art solar power and up-to-date necessities. And a trimaran sailboat. Read people's minds so I can learn which friend is a mother fricker and which finds me attractive. If any of my friends gained the power, I would pretty quickly have zero friends. To come into possession of a very large quantity of money, purchase a huge area of land, and open up the largest nature reserve in the UK and help to rewild the UK. Where me and my ex get back together and I fix my mistakes as a horrible boyfriend and person in general. A future that's with her either married or in a really long relationship. Maybe with kids or not. Be able to provide what she wants and live comfortably. Die of old age with her. You should tell her this if you haven't already. Me being mentally stable. I just wish she liked me, man. I wish he liked me. I feel ya. To live in a Ghibli movie. Me having a GF and being happy with my life. Invulnerability and immortality, which is also my biggest fear. Doctor Who's quote about that always stuck with me. Immortality isn't living forever. That's not what it feels like. Immortality is everyone else dying. Also my desire, yet my greatest fear. The key would be immortality for as long as you want it. So after a few gazillion years you could end your consciousness if you want. Invulnerability, feeling no serious long-lasting pain, needs to be part of the package. Speaking of actual dreams in sleep and such, I had this out-of-this-world experience where I was drinking several thick, velvety-colored juices made out of many gemstones. I'd choose either a cocktail or a single gemstone juice. I don't know where I had this luxury. I remember the taste mentally like the euphoric experience, but never the worldly taste. I wish I can experience that again, as dreams in general. I wish my deceased father for 20 years to be alive, even for a short amount. He passed away when I was a kid and I never got to tell him despite the short time spent. He gave me the best memories of my life. He used to literally stop whatever he was doing, and I'm sure a million times more important, to play with me hide and seek or crack puzzles together, etc. I never got to return the favor as an adult and it makes me feel like I still haven't said thank you. In a time like this, it is amplified because I've an elderly mother and so many people don't really care about their parents, regardless of the pandemic or health measures in general. Sometimes I wonder if I would have been a different person had he lived. I'm so flad to read this, both the dream and more important, Adienly, how grateful you are to your parents. Thanks. It's rare to be appreciative of others these days. My parents are good people and I'm glad I have them in my life. You know why he stopped whatever he was doing. You were a million times more important, less than three. This made me tear up. Thank you. It's tough when I see people loving other people but never saying thank you or acknowledging that. As if they will always have a tomorrow, or have a million chances. Thank you so much for watching and have a good day.